Welcome back. Let's take a look at all the movies releasing this week and whether or not they're worth your time and money.
Papa, I need some money.
How much money can I give you?
Sandeep Mohan writes and directs this comedy drama about a family coming to terms with identity and aging.
And selling bloody underwear is your higher calling.
What business is it you are in?
Underwear. But I'm hoping to get into edible lingerie.
Savio, played by Ash Chandler, is a frustrated sales agent for an underwear company who is planning to launch his own edible underwear venture in Goa.
And cashews.
I'm pregnant! Oh my God! Savio, it's a miracle!
His wife Annie, played by Shahnaz Patel, is a 40-something church-going member of the choir. When Annie suddenly discovers she is pregnant, Savio and she have to delicately handle breaking the news to their adopted teenage daughter Ruth. While you would imagine this to be the catalyst in the film, it isn't. Annie is more bothered about losing her spot in the church choir and her wrinkling face than her unborn baby. Savio is obsessed with his business and with the lovely tourist Natalie. And Ruth is insecure about not looking like her parents.
There is Portuguese in my heart.
There's also a con man, a local gangster and his pot-smoking son, a salsa dancer and a Tibetan waiter. It all gets rather messily entangled, and that's when Mohan loses a grip on his material. The plot is slightly predictable but well set up. But then Mohan seems unsure how to tie up the ends, resulting in a forced and hurried ending. But luckily, the performances keep you engaged. Primarily Silaicha, Rehmani, and mostly Chandler, who excels as the confused, well-meaning, naive, and kind Savio. Sadly, the same cannot be said for Patel, who tries to pass off Parsi as Goan. Love Wrinkle Free looks at Goa the way Goans might, and not the way tourists and the media view it. It is musical, chilled out, quirky, and the pace is susegaad. Watching this movie will surely make you nostalgic for Goan music, bibinka and beaches.
I can only imagine how you feel.
The Men in Black are back, and this time the special agents are going back in time.
There's some secrets out there that the universe don't know about.
Will Smith returns as alien policing agent Jay, who time travels to 1969 to protect his partner, Agent K.
Let's jump.
K?
Josh Brolin steps in to play the younger K. Director Barry Sonnenfeld helms this franchisee for the third time and adds plenty of gadgets, grotesque creatures, and 60s period styling to make MIB3 an enjoyable ride. There are enough wisecracks too. Sonnenfeld also adds some easy-to-miss background gags, be it Lady Gaga's portrait placed alongside other life forms, or a quip about a meeting in 1969 with the Viagrans, who have this revolutionary new pill.
Gotta get high,
my man. For real?
Coming to present day, Boris the Animal, played by Jermain Clement, has just escaped after being imprisoned for 40 years in a high-security lunar facility. His sole aim is to exact his revenge on Agent K. Agent J hopes that by going back to 1969, he can get to K before Boris and change the events in the past, thereby changing the future.
No. Space gun.
This time travel is the best part of a franchise that seems to be spluttering along. Jones looks fatigued and old, and Smith has lost his comedic charm. Thankfully, Brolin injects some freshness into the performances. While the visual effects are great, the 3D technology is wasted. Overall, MIB3 is entertaining, but falls short of expectations.
Hey man, hey, how old are you?
29.
Oof. You got some city miles on you.
Director Arnav Chaudhry's long wait to see his animated epic come alive on the big screen seems to have been worth it.
Meri aankh matra pakshi ki aankh dekh rahi hai acharya.
To chhodo baan.
Based on the Mahabharata, Arjun, the warrior prince, has taken art, drawing and rendering to a new level of respectability on the big screen. As for the story, the first half tells you nothing new. The film splashes around trying to find its individuality and simply establishes the rivalry between the Pandavas and the Kauravas. Given how well-known tales from the Mahabharata are, this section feels flat and dull. The songs too add to your frustration. But Chaudhary revitalizes the film post-interval as the focus shifts to Arjun's rites of passage from boy to warrior. This leads up to the pivotal battle between Arjun and Duryodhan's vast army, which is the precursor to the epic battle of Kurukshetra. The artists and animators create a world that has magnificent palaces, fearless warriors, proud princesses, vast landscapes, regal characters, and violent battles. Although the scenes lack consistency in their execution, a few are particularly worth a mention. Namely, the computer game type fight during Arjun's preparation for war, the underwater bow arrow fish skill test, the chopper contest, and the final battle. As for the voice artist, Yudhvir Bakolia as Arjun fails to bring out the enigma and strength you associate with his character. Vijay Kashyap as Shakuni and Brijesh Jha as Yudhishthir also disappoint. The most convincing are Sachin Khedekar as Krishna and Hemant Mahor as Duryodhan. Although animated, Arjun is aimed more at adults than at children. And as much as it traces the warrior prince's coming of age, it also marks the coming of age of Indian animated features.
And that brings us to news of the week.
The rights of the Sharman Joshi Baman Irani starrer Ferrari Ki Sawari have been sold for a whopping 65 crore rupees. The theatrical rights of this small budgeted film, which has been sold to Eros International, have alone bought in 42 crore rupees. The other rights include satellite, DVD and music makeup for the final figure. Sanjay Leela Bansali's Devdas has been listed in noted film critic Richard Corliss's list of 10 best films of the millennium in Time magazine. The film, which stands at number 8 in this list, features the likes of Moulin Rouge, Avatar, Wall-E, The Lord of the Rings and The Hurt Locker. Ram Gopal Verma's department, which released last week, raked in box office collections of 1.29 crore rupees on the first day. They slipped down to 95 lakh on the second day, and the film made a total of 2.18 crore rupees in its opening weekend. All in all, the film has performed dismally at the box office. Even with Ram Gopal Verma starting the blame game for its failure, it seems unlikely that he would be able to save face.
And that's all the time we have on this edition of Movies, Money and More. Thanks for watching and see you soon.